So he said, okay, this q is there, so dq upon dt is equal to this, and it is this current that he called displacement current. Somehow earlier they used to call the field as a displacement. Okay, so he said it is this, the current due to the changing field. It is a current that is getting produced due to a changing field, correct? Why is field changing? Because q is changing. So in the end, what will happen? In the steady state, when q is there and the capacitor gets cut off, that is fully charged, what happens? There is no change in q. So there is no change in E. If there is no change in E, then there is no change in E into A. That is phi E. And hence this current will drop to zero. So in the space between the capacitors, he argued that there is a current which is this that exists. So he said this thing is not wrong. He said an extra term ID, an extra current ID should be added on the RHS. An extra current ID should be added on the RHS to compensate for the current in the vacuum. Correct. So in the vacuum, or where there is no conductor, you should put this. So he said, does Ampere's law gets modified as, B dot dl is equal to mu naught Ic plus Id. This is conduction current which requires a conductor to move, and this is displacement current.
So
what happens? This mu naught Ic plus mu naught Id, mu naught epsilon naught d phi e upon dt. So
this is what the Ampere's law became after the modification by Maxwell, and it began to be called as Ampere's Maxwell law. Okay,
so this is what it became.
So it became
Ampere's Maxwell law.
Correct? Because this term was modified by Maxwell. Fine? Not only that, wherever you have got a varying charge, that is a varying current. So we'll go into that, you don't worry about it.
This is for the entire circuit.